gentlemen, good evening. May I request you to please rise for the procession of the graduates. Please rise. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening again. May I request you to please rise for the procession of the graduates. Thank you. And now, may I kindly request you to remain standing for the procession of the faculty members. Procession of the university patron, the chairman and members of the board of trustees, the president and the vice president of the American University of Madaba.
Thank you. Your Excellency, Archbishop Pierre Battista Pizzabella, Your Excellency, Bishop William Shomely, Sister Paula Marie Bewley, members of the Board of Trustees, Professor Nabil Ayoub, President of the American University of Madaba, deans and faculty members, graduates and parents, honored guests. Welcome to this ceremony to mark the commencement of the 2018 graduating class of the American University of Madaba. I am Dr. Ihab Sawalha, Dean of Student Affairs. Together with the Vice Dean of Student Affairs, Dr. Hanan Mdanat, it is our pleasure to guide you through this special ceremony. This evening, we come together as a university community to celebrate the achievements of this graduating class. Talent and skills are the crops that are nurtured, groomed, and given all possible opportunities to grow and bloom. Graduation day is the celebration of the harvest of this crop. This is a much awaited event in every student's life, as it gives the reward and efforts put by students throughout their academic journey. It is a day full of joy, a day about pride and accomplishment, a day of celebration. It gives a sense of achievement and a sense of responsibility towards fulfilling further commitments. This evening, we each take part in celebrating with those who are graduating. My role is to let people speak for themselves. To begin with, I would like to invite His Excellency Bishop William Shomely to open these proceedings with a prayer. Please, thank you.
دعاء من أجل الخريجين والخريجات. اللهم الحكيم في أقواله والقدير في أعماله والكريم في عطاياه. نشكرك لأجل ذاتك ولأجل روائع خلقك، ولا سيما الإنسان الذي جعلته قادرا على التعلم والفهم واكتساب الحكمة والعلم ونبذ الشر واتباع الخير واكتساب الأجر. نشكرك اليوم من أجل هذه الكوكبة من الخريجين والخريجات في مختلف الحقول والتخصصات، ولولا فضلك عليهم وتلطفك بهم وتضحيات أهلهم وكدهم وجهدهم لما بلغوا فرحة النجاح التي تغمرهم اليوم. اللهم فرح أهلهم وكافئهم 100 ضعف على إحسانهم. يا رب وفق الخريجين والخريجات لاكتشاف طريقهم في الحياة، من دراسات عليا يواصلونها، أو مهنة كريمة يمارسونها، أو أبحاث علمية جديدة يقومون بها. اللهم نطلب أن يكتمل علمهم بالفطنة، والفطنة بالحكمة، والحكمة بالخلق الرفيع. اللهم بارك هذه الجامعة، مؤسسيها وبناتها، إدارتها ومجلس أمنائها، عمداءها ومحاضريها، موظفيها وطلابها. اجعل هذه الجامعة واحة علم زاخر بالأبحاث تؤدي رسالتها على أكمل وجه. نصلي لأجل الأردن مليكاً وحكومة وشعباً، كي يبقى هذا الوطن آمناً مطمئناً. نصلي لأجل الأردن مليكاً وحكومة وشعباً، كي يبقى هذا الوطن آمناً مطمئناً، كريماً لأهله ومضيافاً لزائريه، أبعد عنا تجربة الغلو والتطرف والفساد والتصلف، واجعلنا ننهج نهج العدل والاعتدال، وأن نسعى دوما وراء الكمال. اللهم أنت السميع المجيب، آمين.
Thank you, Your Excellency. At this point, may I invite AUM's President, Professor Nabil Ayoub, to deliver the President's address.
Your Excellency, Patron of the commencement ceremony of class 2018, Archbishop Pier Battista Pizzaballa, the Apostolic Administrator, Your Excellency Bishop William Shomali, Chairman of the Board of Trustees, Your Excellency Sister Paula Bewley, President of Revere University, keynote speaker of this commencement ceremony, Your Excellencies, dear board members and dear faculty members, dear guests, dear parents and students, congratulations, class 2018. This is the beginning of your career path. Whatever careers you choose, make sure to integrate your knowledge and skills with your innate, true, innovative spirit to roadmap your future plans and take wise decisions. Innovative ideas get mobilized when you work collaboratively and in teams, exchanging experience and expertise with other team members and exchanging and engaging in innovative approaches naturally leads you to non-traditional, out-of-the-box solutions and problem-solving. Our alumni are full of success stories in many fields. Our graduates are sought after by many good-standing companies for their know-how, hard and soft skills. AUM is keen on outreaching to the local community through viable and meaningful initiatives. Charity Pharmacy, Innovation Initiative for High School Students, and training courses by the Consultations, Studies and Training Center are a manifestation of AUM civic engagement. AUM is expanding its academic trajectory of 18 majors distributed over 7 faculties to address market demand and global academic emerging horizons. It is opening 2 new majors this year, Human Resources Management and Design and Visual Communication. AUM thanks the contribution and efforts of all the former chairmen of its boards of trustees. AUM grew out of the diligent work and creativity of the first president, Professor Victor Billy. His dedication to AUM is unwavering, be it as president or as chairman of the Board of Trustees. We thank you all, dear former chairman, for your continued support. Dear graduates, being creative in your career path, taking calculated risks to create new opportunities, taking the road less traveled by, having faith in yourselves, following your hearts, and being grateful to your parents with help will help you excel and prosper. Congratulations to you and to your parents. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you, President. May I now invite our distinguished students, Tina Zabane, Faculty of Health Sciences, Tala Sharqawi and Zaid Ammari, Faculty of Business Administration, to present the valedictory address.
Your Excellency, Archbishop Pier Battista Pizzapella, Your Excellency, Bishop William Shomeli, Sister Professor Paola Mary Bewley, members of the Board of Trustees, President of AUM, Professor Nabil Ayoub, deans and faculty members, graduates and parents, honored guests. Graduates, this is our day. I find myself standing on this podium experiencing numerous kinds of emotions, and I am certain that many of you here emphasize with me on that. It's hard to find the right words to say on this exact day, the day that marks the end of our journey in AUM, only to find another journey and another route ahead of us. At this point, I can't be sure of a lot of things, but I can assure you that being proud and honored doesn't even begin to quantify the depth of gratitude to be standing here, bringing our accomplishments along with us. So this is a round of applause to all of you who made us reach where we are today. Going over memory lane, we had to make serious decisions throughout our educational journeys, both in school and at AUM. We had to plan our future deeply as we grew up. Year by year, people often asked us the golden question. I call it golden because I thought it was that important. This golden question was, what do you want to be when you grow up? Ironically, when I was younger, I easily had the answer to this question. I wanted to be a Disney princess, but that didn't quite work. So I then decided I wanted to become a pharmacist. Huge leap, I know. That was when I started pursuing pharmacy as a major in AUM. To tell you the truth, it was by no means easy. There were many times where my peers and I thought we would never reach the finish line. But with great prevalence, dedication, and hard work, we achieved success. And those struggles have only made this moment even sweeter. As I approached the end of my university years, I knew I would be asked this golden question again, but this time in a different form. What do you want to do when you graduate? If I were to answer this question a few years ago, I would have stuttered. But now, with confidence, I answer that we are ready for whatever life has to offer and whatever opportunities coming our way. Because throughout our years in AUM, we became filled with a relentless determination to succeed and to achieve whatever we set our minds to. We are bound to rise. As we embark on a new chapter of our lives, we take with us the knowledge, the insights, and the experiences we've gained from AUM. We cherish the ambition that AUM implanted in us and presume with constant urge to seek justice, strength, and intelligence in the paths we choose. Being an AUM graduate, we've been led to understand that we should stand up for our basic rights and for our beliefs. We've been led to understand that we must hustle hard if we want to build our own legacies. And most importantly, to understand that we have the choice and the chance to become leaders. Those years spent in AUM taught us the bittersweet reality of the world ahead. It prepared us educationally, mentally, and personally to always raise the bar in everything we do. Not only did it prepare us how to succeed, but also it taught us that it is okay to fall as long as you stand back up stronger than before. As AUM graduates, we are certain and proud of having the capability to shine in a crowd full of people so alike.
At AUM, I have met individuals that inspired me to great lengths, varying from professors to staff members to fellow students. But I am a great believer that some people cross our paths to influence us, enrich us, teach us, and send us ahead to find our own path. Other people, however, they cross our paths to walk by our side, reach out when we need a supporting arm, and bring out the smallest details we wouldn't have realized without them. Both types of people are crucial in the development of oneself. This is a chance for us to thank all those people who have supported us from the backstage, from the front line, all the people who have left us, all the people who are with us, because no one's journey is complete with the people who traveled with us. Graduates, I know we all felt the struggle of walking the distances between the parking lot and lecture halls, between lecture halls and the gym. However, for me at least, the biggest struggle was commuting every single day from Amman to Madaba. But look back at that feeling and compare it to the one you are feeling right now. All the ups and downs you have faced eventually led you to this moment right here, on this stage, in this hall. Despite the differences in our interests, backgrounds, and nationalities, I believe being in a young university brought us together. Every individual was able to put their distinctions to use, whether through extracurricular activities or through expanding our educational horizons. Even on a social level, we were able to widen our circles of connections. One student would introduce you to another, and at some point, you know most of the student body. I bet though at some point, we all felt the pressure of this semi-adult life dawning on us and wanted to take a break. But look at us tonight. We stuck through it all. We sit here feeling the triumph of our own accomplishments, raising our heads high for everything we have overcome over the past years. So for what lies ahead, I challenge you and I encourage you to trust and believe that you can break through anything that is thrown at you. To move away from the life lessons that we portrayed over the past years, I believe it is only fair to end our journey in AEM with a trip across memory lane. I, for one, cannot thank the university enough for the cultural exchange program it offered. I was able to complete a semester in the United States, and I'm sure all international students in the university can relate when I say, living abroad makes you see how much of a blessing it is to live with family members who ease certain necessities for you on a daily basis. But living abroad, in addition to getting your education, gets a lot harder when you need to learn how to cook, how to clean, and clean up the mess behind you. Although it is a big responsibility, traveling abroad was a chance to explore beyond our comfort zones, meet people from different backgrounds, and adapt to cultural changes while acting as an ambassador to your own country. There is a lot to remember during the past couple of years in AUM, from spring races to basketball games that brought students cheering for one university, our university, to the student magazine that was published twice, and I bet some of you just found out about it. My favorite event was International Day, where each nationality dressed with their national clothes bought national food to represent their country. That was a true representation of cultural diversity. I can go on and on naming things that were done in the university, but each one of us had their own diverse and unique experience. And I hope that with all its rises and falls, you look back at your time in AUM and smile.
Fellow graduates, take a good look at your families. They worked harder than you did, slept less than you did. They gave you their heart every time you were on the road. Prayed for you in each exam. I'm pretty sure that tears of joy are running down their cheeks at the moment. Today, I would like to talk about the purpose of our lives. Everyone has a purpose. It might be clear to some of us, but also very blurry for others. All of us are headed into a personal path to reach and achieve a goal. But no one knows what the future holds for everyone. However, I am sure that these 4 years of dedication and commitment have taught us a lot. Building ourselves through the difficulties and the obstacles we faced through our days here. One of the greatest minds in modern history, Steve Jobs, once said, "Have the courage to follow your heart and intuition, they somehow already know what you truly want to become. Everything else is secondary. Every graduate here will tell a great story, and this university will be a part of it. From this day forward, let us believe in ourselves so we can reach our goals and fulfill our dreams. Let us be the best we can be and express our happiness and our pride. We've already taken the steps by making it to the ceremony today. Now, it's time to take the next steps in the journey that is our lives and begin to build our futures. At last, I would like to thank our professors for making us going, for keeping us nurturing while every side of us was weak. They became second family, whether taking the role of fathers, mothers, and even siblings. We appreciate their substantial effort for guiding us every single day through our tough road to success. And finally, we can say, congratulations, class 2018.
Thank you. Thank you, Tina, Tala, and Zaid. It's now my privilege to introduce our esteemed keynote speaker, the Honorable Sister Paula Bulley, President of Riviera University. Sister Paula.
Good evening, everyone, and to Archbishop Pizzabella, to Your Excellency and Chair of the Board, Archbishop Shomali, esteemed board members, distinguished President Ayub, but most especially, the American University Class of 2018. Thank you for this honor to address you this evening. And let us recall the deep roots of the ancient city of Madaba, whose name means calm running waters. Your beautiful city is known as the School of Mosaics. And here there is a deeper meaning. Your valedictorians spoke about friendship, hospitality, cooperation, working together to achieve a goal. That is indeed what we celebrate this evening. This evening also allows me to send greetings to you from the state of New Hampshire in the USA, where AUM is incorporated and recognized. And so this evening, allow me to offer some few words of reflection on the role of the Catholic University in dialogue with faith and culture. AUM is a young university founded in 2011 and yet built on the foundation of medieval universities that gave birth to the mission of integrating faith and reason, incorporating the inspiration of the divine and the aspirations of humankind. Your own AUM community is built on this foundation and is committed to living what I have found to be your outstanding motto of wisdom and science. These characteristics are then joined for the benefit of all, and these are values and tools necessary to build a better world. In a world that cries out for peace and understanding and dialogue, your education at AUM sets you apart and calls for your active participation in civic life. Now let me pause. In Jordan and in the United States and in Europe, commencement speakers are known for giving advice. And so let me share with you three simple phrases that have helped my journey and perhaps will be meaningful to you. Simple phrases that include, do good, be well, give thanks. To do good, you graduates are well prepared to build a just and diverse society. You are engineers, you are scientists, you are computer specialists, you are skilled in business and communications. You shape not only your own future, but the future of this community and your region. We can express this notion of doing good by answering and asking a question, who is my neighbor? And the answer includes the stranger, the traveler, those who are discouraged, those who are simply different. No doubt, you will have opportunities, both great and small, to serve your neighbor. Use your gifts of mind and heart developed at AUM. Take these values into the world. And so let me encourage you quite simply with the gifts that each of you have to do good. Be well. Well-being, of course, includes physical health and balancing family, work, and social responsibilities, and yet it also includes the dimension of spiritual life. You discovered at AUM the ancient wisdom of Socrates. To know thyself is the first step of wisdom. Some may think that well-being is easy. It is not. To know ourselves, we must set aside moments for reflection. We must examine our motives and goals, and we must look beyond one moment to the many moments of the future. As part of this inward journey, you will use the words that are so important in an AUM education. Advance in appreciation of beauty and goodness. Absorb the power of music, of visual arts, of literature. May your journey mirror that of the great men and women of our age. And take some time with the encouragement of your family and friends to be well. Perhaps the greatest two words that we can think of this day are the words to give thanks. Your valedictorians looked at this to give thanks as in a rearview mirror. Today we celebrate your hard work and your achievement, but also the hard work of your families, your mentors, and especially the faculty of the American University of Madaba. Congratulations to the faculty. Gratitude is an attitude of heart and mind. And so in the many days to come, this gratitude will compel you to take action, to see the world from a larger point of view, and most especially, to place your talents and your capabilities at the service of others. And so the final word of advice, to give thanks. Dear friends, and especially members of the class of 2018, I share your excitement and your enthusiasm and the continuation of your journey, especially to employment. May your education at the American University of Madaba lead you to accomplish great works. But just importantly, May your education lead you to do good, to be well, and to give thanks. Congratulations, graduates.
Thank you, Sister Paula. In its journey for superior local and international success, the American University of Madaba is privileged to sign another memorandum of understanding with Revere University, one of the most distinguished and highly reputable universities in the United States. So now I would like to invite Sister Paula Bewley, the president of Revere University, and Professor Nabil Ayoub, president of the American University of Madaba, to sign the memorandum of understanding.
Congratulations to Revere University and the American University of Madaba for this substantial achievement. We will now be pleased to hear a musical performance by the Jordan Academy of Music.
Thank you very much. Alf Mabruk, Tulab Harijin, Jama Amrikia. Alf Mabruk, Asatisa Jama Amrikia. Kachini, Ave Maria. time to say goodbye. Alf Mabruk. Thank you.
Thank you for this inspiring performance. Your Excellency, the ceremony patron, now we would like to request your kind permission to begin the graduation of the class 2018. Dean of the Faculty of Engineering.
students of the Faculty of Engineering, please rise. Dear President, Professor Nabil Ayoub, these students from the Faculty of Engineering have successfully completed all the requirements established by the university and the New Hampshire Higher Education Commission legislation for their bachelor's degree. And based on the regulations of granting academic degrees and certificates at the American University of Madaba, and upon the recommendation of the Faculty Council, the Dean's Council decided to grant these candidates the bachelor degree in civil, mechanical, and electrical engineering. Kindly confer upon these candidates the certificates they deserve.
Department of Civil Engineering, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Tamara Attwal. Abdulrahman Addaour. عبد الله الرفاعي. أحمد جابر. أحمد الشامي. علي الطرشة. عامر محمد. دينا القطيشات. ضياء التميمي. محمد اليحيى. محمد وقاد. ريم إبراهيم. سعد مرجي. سامر السراحين. زهير خلف. Summer semester graduates in civil engineering. أحمد المبيضين. محمد الكيالي. مراد السياج. صلاح عقل. Department of Electrical Engineering, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Ramiz Bannoura. معتصم صافي. Yara Hamarni. Department of Mechanical Engineering, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Abdul Wahid Al Kahla. Abdul Aziz Al Kahla. Ahmed Al Rawi. Amir Abbas. George Haddadin. Isa Abu Zgerba. Jamal Qsous. Farooq Shagari. Summer semester graduates in mechanical engineering. Ayham Oude. Khalid Hammoudi. Muhammad Al-Khatib.
Dean of the Faculty of Science, Professor Bassem Dababne.
Students of the Faculty of Science, please rise. Dear President, Professor Nabil Ayoub, these students from the Faculty of Science have successfully completed all the requirements established by the university and the New Hampshire Higher Education Commission legislation for their bachelor's degree, and based on the regulation of granting academic degrees and certificate of the American University of Madaba, and upon the recommendation of the Faculty Council, the Faculty Dean Council decided to grant these candidates the bachelor degree in biology and biotechnology. Kindly confer upon these candidates the certificate they deserve.
Department of Biology and Biotechnology. Ishaq Aliyasso. Sorry, sir. Ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Marah Jalal Al-Tabbal. Shahad Zuhair. Tala Agha.
Dean of the Faculty of Health Sciences.
Students of the Faculty of Health Sciences, please rise. Dear President, Professor Ayoub, these students from the Faculty of Health Sciences have successfully completed all the requirements established by the university and the University of New Hampshire Higher Education Commission legislation for their bachelor's degree. and based on the regulations of granting academic degrees and certificates at AUM, and upon the recommendation of the Faculty Council, the Dean's Council decided to grant these candidates the bachelor degree in pharmacy, medical laboratories, and nutrition and dietetics. Kindly confer upon these candidates the certificates they deserve.
Department of Medical Laboratories, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Lara Al-Samayin. Al-Hussein Waleed. Dua Al-Majma'i. Majida Foudi. Sana Musa. Tala Atwet. Summer graduate in medical laboratories, Aya Al-Majali. Department of Nutrition and Dietetics, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Tala Dehmes. Lien Barakat. Rihan Abu Taha. Sara Al-Sakit. Summer graduates in nutrition and dietetics, Gianna Al-Husseinat. Reem Awad. Zina Al-Halabi. Department of Pharmacy, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Sahar Al-Faqih. Ansam Shtewi. Aya Dawood. Berta Farah. Haya Arqub. Juman Qubaisi. Lien Shahatit. Majd Andrawos. Marah Al-Mahrouq. Maryam Sayegh. Muhammad Al-Sharrad. Niveen Awabdi. Peter Abdul Malik. Rama Khattab. Tina Zabani. Tuqa Inad. Yazid Aqil. Summer graduates in pharmacy, Ali Al-Zubaydi. Noor Tuqan.
of the Faculty of Information Technology, Dr. Ahmed Daraisa.
Students of the Faculty of Information Technology, please rise. Dear President, Professor Nabil Ayoub, these students from the Faculty of Information Technology have successfully completed all the requirements established by the university and the New Hampshire Higher Education Commission legislation for their bachelor's degree. And based on the regulations of granting academic degrees and certificates at the American University of Madaba, and upon recommendation of the Faculty Council, the Dean's Council decided to grant these candidates bachelor degree in computer science. Kindly confer upon these candidates the certificates they deserve.
Department of Computer Science, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Hiba Shahatit. Amer Barqawi, Firas Subah, Kareem Al Saudi, Kareem Khalaf, Khalil Jidon, Zaid Damer. Summer graduates in computer science: Anas Al-Qannas, Hamoud Abu Qaoud,
Dean of the Faculty of Business and Finance.
Students of the Faculty of Business and Finance, please rise. Dear President, Professor Nabil Ayoub, these students from the Faculty of Business and Finance have successfully completed all the requirements established by the university and the New Hampshire Higher Education Commission legislation for their bachelor's degree. And based on the regulation of granting academic degrees and certificates at the American University of Madaba, and upon the recommendation of Faculty Council, the Dean Council decided to grant these candidates the bachelor's degrees in accounting, business administration, risk management, marketing, and finance. Kindly confer upon these candidates the certificates they deserve.
Department of Accounting. Ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Michael Hanania. Abdel Sattar Al-Ani. Adnan Francis. Amir Abu Al-Adas. Basil Musa. Fadi Bajali, Farah Shaheen, Ghassan Naife, Jafar Qaide, Jamil Lawabde, Jude Al Qawasmi, Maria Consul, Mina Jawad, Michelle Dardas, محمد العجة. محمد الفار. محمد أحمد. مهند درويش. مهند صفدي. مبارك زريقات. أسامة خوري. ركان البيطار. سامح سميح الفرح. سامح الفرح. سوار صوالحة. وائل دياب. ياسر كمال. يوسف الحوراني. زيد زقبابة. Summer graduates in accounting. علاء بواب. فضل الطراونة. فخري الطويل. إبراهيم طبرة. لما الرماوي. منذر الفاخوري. نادين حدادين. توفيق مسنات. وليد السلع. Department of Business Administration. Ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Saro Chakaman. Abdul Ilah Hassan. Amjad Al Mayah. Aya Al Hurut. Dana Samur. دانيا صفدي. هيثم فراج. ليانا النشاشيبي. لجين غوشه. معاوية المحدين. محمد غوكشو. ناصر الدرباس. نور الضني. شذا الكيلاني. طارق القمحاوي. زيد تكريتي. زين الفايز. Summer graduates in business administration, Ahmed Athamni. Ahmed Dajani. Fakhri Asadiq. Faris Sudani. Khalid الملكاوي. خالد قويدر. خالد فرحان. لؤي السيد. مرام مروان الحسيني، عدي نصار، طارق كردي، Department of Banking and Finance, ranked first and recipients of the Academic Excellence Award, Raghad Jamjoom. Aida Al-Fayez. Anas Al-Tabarani. Aya Al-Nu'aymi. فادي سعاد. فراس تادروس. جود جمو. ليلى العلي. بلاء الفريشة. نادر الأرملي. بانو القيسي، دينا جودة، حسن نابلسي، حسين العبيدي، إبراهيم السعودي، لارا جمو، محمود سعد الدين، مجد الشامي، ناتالي مطالقة، نور زريقات، روان دبابني، ريم العتال، طلال فارس، زيد عماري، سمر جراجويتس ان ماركتينج، عبد الله ابو زيد، عدنان البيطار، عدنان كنعان، أمير فاخوري، عائشة أبو السمن، حسن أبو المعالي. مجد حجازين. ريم صوان. سارة نوفل. طلال قطب. Department of Risk Management, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Dina Rabah. Abdul Hamid Al-Battiqi. Abdullah Dawoodiye. عادل عواملة. أحمد هنيدي. أحمد الحاوي. أماليا شتاوي. أسد الدين جابر. غزل بكير. خالد عبدين. ليان حمدان. لينا مدادحة. لؤي الطراونة. لبنى عطية. مجد أبو رميلة. مالك الأطرش. ميري قمر. ميشيل أبو عيطة. محمد غزال. محمد فرحان. محمد عطلة. مصطفى قطيشات. نادين قرالة. رعد صوالحة. رنا مصاروة. رزق الله حداد. تالا عريضة. تالا الشرقاوي. ورد أبو جبارة. يولا خوري. سمر graduates in risk management. عبد الله عبد الحفيظ. أندرو سبانخ. حمزة شولي. محمد إلياسو. طلال الحلبي. وائل المولى. زيد ريماوي.
Dean of the Faculty of Architecture and Design, Professor Naif Haddad.
Student
of the Faculty of Architecture and Design, please rise. Dear President, Professor Nabil Ayoub, these students from the Faculty of Architecture and Design have successfully completed all the requirements established by the university and the New Hampshire Higher Education Commission legislation for their bachelor degree. And based on the regulation of granting academic degree and certificates at the American University of Madaba, and upon the recommendation of the faculty council and the Dean's Council, decided to grant these candidates the bachelor degree in architecture, interior design, and graphic design. Kindly confer upon these candidates their certificates they deserve.
Department of Graphic Design, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Mayas Imran. Ali Hadraj. Anoud Al-Nasser. Tala Abu Raghib. Summer graduates in graphic design, Noor Dawoodia. Department of Architecture, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Rua Schreider. Afnan Jamjoum. Fahed Sunukrot. Hala Haman. Haya Musa. Jana Burek. Mahmoud Rimawi. Musa Abdelaid. Sama Sweety. Samira Isa. Suha Al-Hindi. Summer graduate in architecture, Fahed Asad. Aisa Ibrahim. Nasreen Al-Saadi. Rand Al-Naber. Raya Al-Shabib. Razan Qa'in. Shahid Al-Safadi. Department of Interior Design, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Haya Zorob. Aram Khzouz. Asma Qubaisi. Aya Abu Gharbiya. Hanadi Ghazi. Hiba Harb. Laith Qubti. Lean Al-Kayali. Maisir Reem Safi. Ribhi Yaqub. Reem Al-Assi. Ruwaida Assad. Sandra Kishek. Sara Armush. Suleiman Abu Hani. Zaid Haddad. Summer graduates in interior design. An Yaqub. Firas Jabiri. Marah Dali. Noor Suwan. Rand Nasreddin. Serena Sawalha. Taysir Alidwake. Dean of the Faculty of Languages and Communication, Dr. Wafa Khadra.
Students of the Faculty of Languages and Communication, please rise. Dear President, Professor Nabil Ayoub, these students from the Faculty of Languages and Communication have successfully completed all the requirements established by the university and the New Hampshire Higher Education Commission legislation for their bachelor's degree. And based on the regulations of granting academic degrees and certificates at the American University of Madaba, and upon the recommendation of the Faculty Council, the Dean's Council decided to grant these candidates the bachelor degree in English language and literature and a bachelor degree in translation. Kindly confer upon these candidates the certificates they deserve.
Department.
الرجاء من جميع الطلاب والطالبات الخريجين الالتزام بأماكنكم والأهالي الكرام لو سمحتم الرجاء تكرم بالجلوس لو سمحتم الطلاب الخريجين رجاء الجلوس لو سمحتم
Department of English Language and Literature ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Lynn Katuni, Diana Khuzuz, Farah Shaban, Noor Snobar, Helena Ghishan, Summer graduates for English Language and Literature, Aisha Yahya, Bayan Assamur. Department of Translation, ranked first and recipient of the Academic Excellence Award, Yusuf Ramzi Taha, Malik Amro. Summer graduates in translation, Ramla Jabburi, Tala Barham. Please, let us all rise for the national anthem.
Thank you.
we leave, sincere apology to our student, Amir Abbas from the Mechanical Engineering for pronouncing his name as Amir. Amir Abbas, Mabruk. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please remain at your places until the dignitaries and faculty members have left the room. Congratulations, graduating class of 2018. Congratulations. Alf Mabruk.